Hey guys, and welcome back to a brand new episode of my F1 2019 career mode, here today for round 11 of the season for the Hungarian Grand Prix and pretty much the start of the second half of the season. If you guys missed the last race for round 10 for the German Grand Prix at the Hockenheim, guys, go watch the episode by clicking the card in the top right hand corner of the screen. It was a fantastic race and lots of action throughout, so go watch it, guys. And yeah, I'm giving you a fair chance before spoilers come into place in this video. Now for this one, you can see on screen we have nice dry conditions all weekend long here at the Hungaroring Ring, and for this weekend we actually have two upgrades on the car, and they are two major upgrades. So it's going to be a big push, one for the aero and one for the chassis. More specifically, one for the weight reduction and another one for the drag. So I'm looking forward to this. What's it going to mean, though, for the R&D graph? You can see on screen, we take a massive step towards the midfield. Unfortunately for us, Toro Rosso have actually brought a big upgrade package of their own. But overall, if you compare Australia to now, look how much closer we are to Mercedes than at the start of the season. So overall, the grid's getting a lot closer, and it's very, very exciting. And we've also got a major engine upgrade on the way for the next race. So hopefully we can add to that in this episode here today, if all goes well, because then we'll have a big chance of really getting into the midfield. And then once we get into the midfield battle, I feel like we can then focus on durability, reliability, and also improving other areas not of the car, but of the team, you know, in terms of reducing the chance of R&D failures and also the cost, making it a lot cheaper. So yeah, overall, like I said in the last episode, I'm probably going to look to keep pushing with R&D until about Singapore, maybe Suzuka. And then we're going to switch focus to next season, because we want to try and, you know, make some big gains over the winter. So yeah, overall, we're going to jump into qualifying here at Hungary. And overall, I tried to do 110. It was just a bit too much for me around here. You know, I was about 6 tenths, 8 tenths off of Robert Kubica, my own teammate. And I normally use him as a reference. So I'm actually going to go down to 108 for this. And the first time I've used 108 since, I think it might have been Baku, actually. I used 105 in France, but other than that, it's been 110 the entire season. And we used 108 in Bahrain, China, Baku, and once again here today. So yeah, overall, that's the plan going forward. Hope you guys understand. As always, I use Kubica as a reference point. But first of all, we've got some more trouble in qualifying.
Okay, I know you're eager to get out there, but I'm going to need you to be patient for a few minutes. We're just trying to zero in on an oil leak.
I think for the third time in three races, we've had some kind of issue at the start of Q1, which is not in my plans, not ideal. But nonetheless, we're going to run aboard now for my best lap in Q1. And it was actually my first run. So let's see what we do with this lap, and let's see what we can pull out of the bag. Realistically, we're not looking too good for Q2. The Williams is struggling around here a little bit, but if I can pull something out of the bag, you never know. So here we go then, straight away on the pit straight down towards turn one, looking for the 50 meter ball. You want to break just before that, down to second gear. Make sure you pick up your apex and really focus on your exit out of here and open up DRS on the exit to really make sure you get some good straight line speed here as we now go down towards turn two. A little bit of a lock up on the front left, but we managed to get the rotation and get a short shift in to make sure you pick up the power nice and early, flat out through three. And there we go, sector one is done and dusted as we now go in towards the start of sector two, throwing the car over the hill, over the crest and over the bump, and now bring it over to the left-hand side for another long right-hander here. You try and get the power as soon as you can. Use the curb and also the tarmac on the left-hand side for traction, and then throw it over the curb to the chicane. Don't be too rash or erratic, because you will lose lap time, and now it's all about car downforce and just letting the car roll through these long left, rights, and lefts. It's all about, you know, having a good car underneath you around here. There's not much you can do except for just hoping the car does the work for you, as we're currently 1.1 down on Lewis Hamilton after two sectors. And this sector here, sector three, is what I was actually losing most of my time and really struggling with. So let's see how we get on here as we go towards the penultimate corner, keeping it relatively tight, focusing once again on our exit. A little bit of oversteer just kicks in there, but we don't lose too much time, and then keeping it nice and tight through the final corner on the power as soon as possible, open up DRS up to the line, and let's see where that puts us. And it's going to be P15 actually, so it was at the time good enough to jump into Q2, but I believe there was people behind yet to set a lap time. And there we go, straight down to P16 already as the car behind improves. And yeah, I tried to go for another run, and it was very, very close, very marginal. And I think I made a couple of mistakes. I could have definitely improved, but then I ran wide out of that right-hander there, unfortunately for us. And yeah, that lap's going to be in the bin. And that corner there as well also wouldn't have counted because we ran wide as well. So yeah, overall, we tried to improve. There wasn't much time left on the table my first lap at all, really. You know, it's very rare that I leave time on the table. But yeah, that first lap was just so good. It was by far my quickest lap of the weekend. I made a few adjustments with the aerodynamics into qualifying. I actually lowered the front wing a little bit, and also took a risk by reducing the rear ride height a bit, and it paid off, and we found a little bit more pace, and we actually qualified Kubica by 4 tenths, which was quite surprising to me. And yeah, we didn't have that lap time, you know, we were struggling to get below the 17s, you know, so really, really happy that one. And we managed to out-qualify Toro Rosso in the process as well, which is fantastic. So yeah, overall, a decent Q1 and exceeding expectations here, but we're still going to start from the penultimate row of the grid. With that being said, let's jump into it. It's time for the race here at Hungary, and hopefully we can try and pull something out of the bag with strategy. So yeah, let's see how we get on. It's time for round 11 for the Hungarian Grand Prix.
It's always wonderful to come back to the lively Hungaroring. A popular destination this, nice and close to the beautiful city of Budapest, with some exciting racing to boot. Who can forget Michael Schumacher pushing his old teammate Rubens Barrichello up towards the pit wall in 2010, or those great races of 2014 and 2015 as well. 14 corners then for our drivers to navigate at the 2.7-mile Hungaroring today. It's 6 lefts and 8 rights around a lap here, with average speeds in the region of 120 miles per hour. Also here, of course, is Anthony Davidson. Now, I want to ask you about Lewis Hamilton. They've got a really good lead in the championship going into this weekend, so it feels to me that they've got one hand on the trophy.
Let's not get too ahead of ourselves, Crofty. Yes, it looks like a big lead, but all it takes is a locked brake into turn one, a sticky wheel nut in the pit stop, and that could all get turned on its head. You can never discount one more sting in the tail.
Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, and Max Verstappen lines up alongside. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Leclerc, Bottas, Sebastian Vettel, and Sainz, Perez, Ricciardo, Magnussen, and Daniel Kvyat, Raikkonen, Hülkenberg, Lando Norris, and Grosjean. Gasly, they've taken a grid penalty. Giovinazzi, Lance Stroll, and Martinez. Albon and Robert Kubica takes the last spot on the grid. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
Right, here we are then on the grid for the Hungarian Grand Prix, starting from 18th place on the grid, and it's going to be a pretty straightforward one here today. I think a lot of people in front of us are going to start on the mediums, like in the last race at the Hockenheim. I think it's going to be the exact same story here today, and strategy is going to be quite non-flexible, if that makes sense, and it's going to be down to more on-track overtakes and just general race pace. So yeah, in terms of strategy though, on our end, we're going to start the race on the mediums and then go onto the hard tires. And in terms of fuel, I'm actually going to go, I think, one lap more and go to our usual amount. I think fuel consumption should be okay around here, and we only need it for the pitch straight mainly. So yeah, we're going to try that and see how it goes. No rain expected, so it's going to be quite a tricky one to pull off, but hopefully we can have a good race, and fingers crossed it turns out okay for us. With that being said though, let's jump into it. It's time for round 11 for the Hungarian Grand Prix. Let's get to work. Right, here we go then. Let's build up the revs and get ready for the 5 red lights here at the Hungarian Grand Prix. Lights out, away we go. Not the best start, struggling in that initial phase. We do actually get a good second phase at the start. How brave do I want to go on the brakes into turn one? I fancied it down the inside there, but I know I'm going to have trouble keeping my front wing in one piece. On the power though, we're going to just squeeze Albon, who was trying to go on the outside, down the inside of Stroll and Giovinazzi into turn two. Three wide here, we're going to just get in front though, and the McLaren of Grosjean getting a slow exit because of Gasly in front. Seems like Pierre has a penalty in that red ball, starting further back, but we had such a good one on Grosjean there, I could have maybe gone for the move. The AI tend to go quite slow on the brakes here into the chicane, so we might have an opportunity to go down the inside of Romain Grosjean. Yes, we do, there we go. Up to P15. Aggressive start from us, and it pays off as we make up a handful of places. Let's see if we have race pace to hang on to these guys. A little bit off in qualifying, but you know, in the last race in Hockenheim, we was off in qualifying, but in the race, we had much better race pace, so hoping for more of the same here today, as we go for the one-stop strategy. But so far, so good as lap one draws to a close. Let's try and get a head down and try and set into this race, and most importantly, stay within a second, and stay within DRS of the cars in front. Already struggling to hang on here as we come towards the end of lap two. Onto the start of lap three, Grosjean behind, looking for a move in the McLaren. We get a good exit though.
Okay, entering lap 3 now. DRS has been enabled.
Well, I think it's only a matter of time. I think we are struggling for race pace. I need the cars in front to battle if we want to have any chance of trying to score, you know, a decent finish here today in a decent position. A little bit of oversteer there. Better lap from us as we close up to the cars in front, which is good. Decent middle sector there, much better than last lap. And we've closed back up to Pierre Gasly, which is good news, because DRS is now enabled, so very important. As we've got also, I think, a slow moving car. I think there's Carlos Sainz at the front of it in the McLaren. He retired in the last race, so maybe more trouble for the McLaren driver. Okay, it seems like Sainz isn't the issue, it's somebody else. I think it might be a Ferrari. Yeah, I think it's a Ferrari. We'll see who it is, but definitely one of the red cars, as we're getting close to Pierre Gasly here now. Very, very close. Fancying a move down the inside. Side by side with the Red Bull. Right the outside. Inside for the next one. There we go. Cheeky move. Pierre trying to squeeze me into the curb at the chicane, but I was having none of it as we get past the Red Bull up to P14, and it is the Ferrari that's struggling, without a doubt. I think it's Sebastian Vettel, just caught a glimpse of a white helmet. Let's see if we can make up a few more positions here. We've saved up a nice bit of ERS. We're going to see how much we struggle there for straight line speed here, I think. We're going to have to turn the engine up, give it everything, just to stay competitive. Norris, surprisingly, doesn't go for the slipstream. Down the inside of Lando into turn one, a little bit of a wheel banging again. As we get a lock up, a little bit of issues under traction as Lando gets back in front. Going to go around the outside though of Norris and Sebastian as well. No, not quite, but we do take Norris, putting the squeeze onto the McLaren. Now let's try and get past the Ferrari of the struggling Sebastian Vettel. Good exit there. Down the inside into the chicane. Late one on the brakes, but I was going to send it because I didn't want to lose time through this section and sit behind that Ferrari, as Gasly's actually made the move as well. He's got past with me, so he's making good progress in that Red Bull. But we're up to P12 now. We've used the traffic to our advantage and made some very nice moves, some very cheeky moves, but it's worked out in our favour. If I could just stay within DRS of the three cars in front, that would really help me out. Okay, I think Gasly might have got damaged or had a car problem, because he's been overtaken by Norris, and he wasn't that quick behind me anyway. So you might have got a wing damage passing Vettel possibly, or had a car problem. Either way, we've got a nice bit of breathing space behind us, and we're actually hanging in there with these guys with DRS, so we did a good job here. I know I could beat that Toro Rosso because that's a car we've beaten before, so I know P11's at least achievable, and then it's all up, you know, to find one more position to try and scrape some points. But for now, we're in the mix, and that's where we need to be, as Hülkenberg goes for one of the Toro Rosso here. We're just going to bide our time and not overcommit now, because we've got ourselves into this position. So I want to try and make sure I don't throw it away with a silly mistake. I've got a lot more pace than Kvyat, I can tell already. And I don't want to let Hülkenberg get away, preferably. So I want to try and pass Kvyat ASAP. Let's get the pressure on. Maybe we can go for a move on the pit straight. I need to have a strong end to the lap. This is where I struggle compared to the AI these final few corners. Okay, that's not too bad for the final corner. Kvyat will have DRS, so it's going to be tricky to pass. I don't think it's going to happen right now unless we have some incredible straight line speed, which we know we don't really have. We are gaining, but not enough. Could have gone for the brakes there, maybe, but it would have been too risky. I know for sure this lap though, Kvyat won't be in DRS anymore, so that'll be my chance to get past. So let's just keep the pressure on him for now. Kvyat's still hanging on. I think he's going to have DRS again, unfortunately. I'm just going to make it harder for me. But a better exit this time though. But I still think I'm too far back. I took a little while to get into Rich Mix. He doesn't actually have DRS. I thought he would have, but he doesn't. Oh, I have to back out. Kvyat was good on the brakes. I wasn't quite brave enough, so we almost lost our front wing there. I had to yield. I need to get past him next time around, that I really do. Otherwise, we're losing too much time to the cars behind. Okay, this time we're going to make it happen. Let's get a good exit. We're much closer this time. On the power, DRS. It should be a fairly simple overtake now. Here we go. Down the inside we're going to go. Release the brake a little bit. Run it nice and hot so Kvyat can't hold around the outside. And there we go, we pick up the DRS once again. Meanwhile, Hülkenberg in front, battling with the Alfa Romeo. Good chance for me to try and catch up now. As we're now up to P11 and just shy of the point. Just starting to struggle a little bit on my current rubber. Tires are starting to fade. The battle in front hasn't really taken place, hasn't really taken off between Hülkenberg and Raikkonen. And there's another Haas and Renault just a little bit further up the road. So we're not a million miles away from points, but the cars behind are starting to stack up already. We shouldn't be too far away from the pit stops though, because I need some fresh rubber, I really do. Oh, yellow flag behind.
VSC deployed, the virtual safety car has been deployed. We need to keep a positive delta here. Slow down, maintain a positive delta. Drop your speed, our delta is too low and we'll risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately.
Right, I'm going to pit in this lap. I was going to do it anyway, regardless of the VSC or not. But hopefully the VSC stays up long enough that we can cash in and pit in. Gotta take it very easy with the delta. I don't want to push it too much.
Virtual safety car is ending. Maintain your pace until the green flag. VSC ending. Wait for green. VSC ending. We're going green. Maintain positive delta until the green flags.
Into the pit lane. Here we go. We've got through the VSC period. We probably won't gain much. Nobody else has come in, so we might gain a little bit from that, but not a great amount. But here we go then onto the hard tyres. We're going to get off these softs, or these mediums, sorry.
Complete, go now.
I wonder if the AR staying out are going to try and stretch this to a soft tyre and pit in.
Stay clear of the white line on the exit. We'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross over into the track.
My guess is they may come in like lap 20 for a soft tyre. So if they do, I've got to use these laps to use this hard tyre up before they have the advantage. Well then, onto the pit straight. Looks like Sebastian Vettel pits in for the Haas, along with Lando Norris. And also, we've got a Renault here, Nico Hülkenberg. Look how close we've got to the Renault. He's going to be on cold tyres for the points. Unfortunately, he has DRS, so I can't really get anywhere near him on this straight. But if I can follow him, that'd be fantastic. Because that's points right there. And I think Kimi in the Alpha stayed up for another lap, so if he pits in now, he could be in trouble, so let's try and follow Nico as best as we can. Okay, cars in the pit lane. No Alfa Romeo though, as we jump up to P13. There's an Alfa now leaving the pit lane. So if that's the case, Hülkenberg really lost a lot of time in the pit lane. I don't know what happened to him, but there's the Alfa just up the road. So yeah, Nico lost a hell of a lot of time. Wow. Personal best, more cars in the pit lane. Up to P11 we go. And there's points right there, Nico Hülkenberg. If we could score points in this race, I'll be absolutely amazed. But look at the cars in front as well, on the mini-map. There's a Toro Rosso there, so that could be interesting. Oh, my teammate's out, damn it.
Virtual safety car, reduce speed immediately and keep a positive delta.
Okay, two VSCs in one race.
Okay, slow down, slow down. Is negative, which means you are too fast. Reduce your pace.
Not something I've had too often in this career mode, but yeah, overall it's a good thing because it's going to let me cool the tyres down and also get fuel and ERS back on target. But we're looking good here. We're following Nico quite nicely. I'm liking this. Let's see if anybody else pits. If they do, they're going to hit the jackpot. Doesn't look like it though.
Virtual safety car is ending. Maintain your pace until the green flag. VSC ending. Wait for green.
Okay, there we go, mid-straight, we've had to turn the engine up. And lucky enough, I'm going to get the RS, so we're going to just close back up to Nico a little bit, because he just pulled away from us. opening there for track extension. And that Toro Rosso is actually a lap car. Hülkenberg's going for it though. After this restart, he's trying to stretch me and pull away. I've got to try and close the gap and stay within DRS. Come on. Hopefully I've done enough. Yes, we have. Still within 1 second of the Renault. Let's try and close the gap a little bit in the straight. Personal best, 120.2. Trying to keep up with Hülkenberg as best as I can. But he's running at a very strong pace. We are catching Kimi Räikkönen though in the Alfa, which is good. At least I think it's Kimi. Either way, we're catching the Alfa Romeo in front of us, so let's keep pushing. That might just be the death blow. Little mistake there. Locking up. That might just drop me out of Nico's DRS. Yeah, it has. We've dropped out. I couldn't hang on anymore. I was on the limit every single lap. But Hülkenberg just too quick now. Let's see if we can try and get back in somehow. It's so frustrating just seeing the points be right there. But we just don't have enough to challenge. Hülkenberg isn't dropping me though. We're still hanging in there about a second. 1.5-ish. Maybe his tyres might fade, you never know. Although I am on older tyres, I've got the oldest tyres of everybody here. So mine will probably go first, but I'm trying to keep pushing. I've given it everything on this lap. One last try to get back within DRS of the Renault. I may have just let myself down though. No, I haven't, we've done it. We've got ourselves back in. At the expense of all my fuel and ERS, I'm going to try and get back in range one more time. Because this will guarantee at least P11 in this race. But there we go, we've grafted, we've worked so hard. That was a great lap from me though, I gave it everything. That was my last chance, because I see Sebastian Vettel's making progress behind, so I want to get back within range of Hülkenberg and maybe even try and challenge possibly, or save some fuel in the RS whilst running behind him. But I need to get a little bit closer, you know, before I do that. I think we've dropped out again, guys. Yep, we've dropped out again. I'm trying my hardest. I'm running out of fuel in the RS to try and hang in there, but yeah, I don't think it's going to happen. We're lacking a little bit of pace that I just don't have. The guys behind are battling very heavily now. They have been for some time. And Sebastian Vettel's trying to make his way through, but they've lost a lot of time. They're now pretty much 5 seconds behind me with three more laps to go. We're looking pretty good here to bring this one home in P11. All I can pray for is a retirement in front of me. Someone DNFs, and that's going to give me the points. But if not, it's going to be P11 here today. Sebastian Vettel's broken free behind us, but he didn't do it with enough time to spare, and he's not going to challenge me at all as we end off the race here in a very decent P11, I've got to say. I've enjoyed the race. It's been a bit of a tough one at times, but having said that, pleasantly surprised by the pace of the car out here in race trim. Much better than quali, as Lewis Hamilton wins once again, and that's going to be a massive statement for the championship. Dare I say, put one hand on the championship for him. But we're going to come through the final corner, and we're going to fall just shy of the points, but still a very, very decent P11 for the Hungarian Grand Prix. Get in.
All right, race over. Take care of the car on the way in.
So Mercedes have won it, and what a great race it was. Tell me, Ant, how did they manage to achieve this win?
I think a large part of the result comes down to temperament. They were able to keep their heads when everyone around them was losing theirs. And that's allowed them to get the best out of the car, to maximise the strategy, and to stay out of trouble.
Mercedes are on top form once again after an excellent race weekend. It's great to see them up on that podium once again.
Right, so here we have the final race results then for the Hungarian Grand Prix. Lewis Hamilton picks up the win for Mercedes, and yet another win for him, and also picking up the fastest lap of the race a massive statement of intent for the championship from Lewis Hamilton after a couple of poor races. He's won the last three, I believe, including this one, and he's dominated. Valtteri Bottas P2, Max Verstappen P3, Charles Leclerc only fourth in the first, and the only of the Ferraris to score points here today. And then we've got Carlos Sainz, best of the rest, fair play to him in the McLaren, really good job. Perez, Ricciardo, Magnussen, Raikkonen and Hülkenberg round off the top 10. We just missed out on the points after trying all race long, but we just lacked that little bit of pace and we didn't quite have the edge. Sebastian Vettel P12 after having car trouble earlier on in the Grand Prix, and then Norris, Grosjean, Gasly also with issues in this race, with Stroll, Kvyat, Albon finishing up the 18 classified runners, with Kubica and Giovinazzi retiring from the Grand Prix here today. In terms of the standings after that race, we still remain at P11. Sainz, though, up to P12, and he's breathing down our neck in the McLaren. And we've got a few cars starting to line up now in the form of Ricciardo, Hülkenberg and Sainz, all looking to overtake me there for P11. In terms of the constructors, though, we are still, you know, holding 18 points, but we have dropped down eventually now to P9. It was, you know, a matter of time. Renault were knocking on the door, and they've eventually taken 8th place. But, guys, that is it for the race, and we already have one major engine upgrade on the way for the next race in Belgium, and we're going to add to that here today. So let's jump into the laptop and let's see what we have available and potentially add another upgrade to the car going into the power races at Belgium and Monza.
You were cutting your way through the field during the race. Would you say that your rival is still on your level? We all underestimated you, didn't we? Appreciate your time.
Okay, so it's time for a contract negotiation, and I've currently drawn up my new contract. We're going to go for 19th in qualifying position, 15th in the race, first driver, hard team goals, and then every single perk on level 3. If you look at our value compared to the contract value, I think this is very easily achievable. So let's see if we get exactly what we want.
Okay, that proposal looks good. It seems all parties are happy with the deal, so it'll commence at the next race weekend.
Now that is what I'm talking about. Absolutely perfect. And we've also got 1,500 points to spend, so we're going to try and spend those. At the moment, I believe I had a team goal before of scoring 3 world championship points. And, you know, you guys obviously seen the last 2 races, we didn't quite do that. So we're going to have a new one in the next race. But for now, you can see on screen we have a major engine power upgrade on the way for Belgium. And that should take us above Toro Rosso. But just to confirm it and to make sure that we do overtake them, I'm going to make some upgrades here. And the chassis is very close to being level now with Toro Rosso. The aero is still a little way off, but we're definitely getting there. And for me personally, this car needs one thing. And it's not actually performance related. It's actually tire wear. We're really struggling with this, so I'm going to put an upgrade of tire wear on straight away, and we still have 1,000 points to spend, so we could also invest in some more aerodynamic work. And looking at the points we have, I am tempted to do this drag reduction because it is power circuits up next, and we need to cut the drag in this car, you know, as much as we can. So I'm going to do that one as well, and then eventually we'll get around to doing this rear downforce one. But for now, we're going to save the rest of those points and invest those in the next episode. So for the next episode, guys, you can see in the bottom right, we're going to have one major engine upgrade and 2 minor aero and also chassis ones. And all together, those 3 upgrades are going to mean we should hopefully overtake Toro Rosso and, dare I say, get very, very close to Alfa Romeo Racing. As you can see on screen right now, that's going to really cut the gap. And going into Belgium, we should be pretty much, you could say, a midfield team. So guys, that is going to be it for this episode of Career Mode. If you did enjoy it, drop a like on the video and also get subscribed if you are new for daily Formula 1 content, and also turn on notifications to not miss any videos from me. And finally, check out these 2 videos on your screen if you have missed them. But other than that, guys, thank you for watching. I'll see you on my next one very soon. But until then, it's goodbye from me.